Hey guys, what's going on? I hope everyone's doing great today. Tairaku back here again with another raid video. Today, I'm actually in a different account. You may see, obviously, level 69 instead of my other account, which is almost level 81 now. So this is actually my old account, my original account. And I switched to the other one. It's got some better champions, but I want to show you guys something in this account specifically that I worked on a long time ago. And there's an uncommon champion who's been talked about a lot lately, okay? That champion is Armiger. Now, Armiger is amazing in a lot of areas. I know Cold Brew used him against the Spider. Spider 20 used several Armigers. And a lot of, the reason why Armiger's been getting a lot of attention lately is because he's absolutely amazing against the Scarab King. Armiger is probably one of the champions with the best, most consistent turn meter reduction. I mean, it's known as A1 ability. Obviously, Allure has it, but he's an uncommon. Like, there's no problem in getting him. Very easy to book. And he has this ability. Like, literally, both his two abilities he has are both extremely useful in a lot of areas in the game. I mean, we got damage based off of enemy max HP on his A2, two-turn cooldown. Like, that's nothing. When it's booked, super easy to book. You can literally just open up a bunch of mystery shards. You can book him. Very easy champion to get duplicates of. And you can buy him from the shop. So either get him from your shards or buy them from the marketplace. Very easy. You may even have to refresh it a few times. Not a big deal. Now, Armiger is very near and dear to my heart. Now, the reason why I say that is because let me show you guys something real quick, okay? Now, if you watch the stream, which is twitch.tv/Tairaku, every day except for Tuesdays and Thursdays from 11 p.m. to 3 a.m. Eastern time, then you'll probably know that on this account, especially if you're a longtime viewer, that I never pulled one specific game-changing champion, okay? And it was a meme on the channel for a while. I actually have an emote made after this champion. While I'm scrolling through here, go ahead and like the video for one, but comment down below who you think the champion who I've never pulled but is an absolute game-changer is, okay? And this champion is a rare, all right? So it looks like I got most of the rares here. I got all the void rares, and it's a void rare. I'm gonna go ahead and tell you that, okay? So I got most of a good amount of champions here, not the newer ones, because this account's kind of old and I haven't been on it recently. I mean, it's basically got all the daily login rewards done. So most of the champions who've been out for a while, I have them, have all the void rares, have them, okay, looking good. Every single undead rare. Oh look, let's click on the, I guess I skipped them by accident. Oh, the single champion who I needed to get through Spiders 20 easier, get through Fire Knight easier, all those areas of the game, I'm missing this one specific champion, okay? Now, Coldheart is an amazing champion for so many areas of the game, but when you don't have her, you gotta work around it, okay? And if I would have pulled Coldheart on this account, I very well may have said, you know what, forget Armiger, not even gonna build him, he doesn't really have any use for me. Until the Scarab King came out, and actually Armiger does have a very big use. But if you're somebody who's early in the game, I'm gonna go ahead and enter this dungeon while I'm talking about it. If you're somebody who's early in the game, and I'm gonna show you the team, and then after this run, I'm gonna show you guys my builds for all these champions on this team, okay? This account's not crazy whatsoever when it comes to builds, and very basic Fire Knight 20 team. Now, if you're somebody early in the game, mid-game, would I invest in a champion who is only good for Scarab King? Like, the Doom Tower is awesome, but I mean, if you're only doing normal mode, is that really that big of a deal? Like, should you invest in Armiger? Armiger is a great champion for the Doom Tower, but no, I wouldn't, like, necessarily. Because the Doom Tower is not necessarily like a progressional area of the game. You can get some decent crafting materials, but overall, I mean, it's not nothing you should be investing in champions for specifically, in my opinion. Now, I want to show you Armiger and how he can do in the Fire Knight and how he can actually take your team and push them through the Fire Knight and do very, very well to maybe give you more of a reason to take somebody like Armiger, who can do very good against the Scarab King, but also has a ton of utility in other areas of the game. I'm going to show you his gear after this. I'm going to show you his masteries, but I mostly want to showcase to you what he does against the Fire Knight. Now, this can go to like the minute and a half mark, and I'm going to go ahead and just fast forward this to the actual Fire Knight. As soon as I start it, I'll pick the video back up there. Nobody wants to watch this 4-minute Fire Knight run. It takes so long. But I do want to showcase to you how good Armiger is. All right, guys, so we're at the Fire Knight now, just now starting. Now, first off, I want to go ahead and let you know there's a few champions here who are making this a lot easier. Tomb Lord does, I believe, reduce turn meter if they're like above 50% HP, very situational, very conditional. And he was a big help for me in clearing the Fire Knight. Also, I do have Yanaka, who's another champion who has a multi-hit on ability one, kind of similar to how Coldheart has a multi-hit. So it helps out a ton. These two champions are very important. But once the Fire Knight's turn meter is actually reduced, Armiger is going to be crucial in keeping his turn meter down. Making him fast is extremely important. Like I said, I'm going to get through here and actually show you guys how he's built. I'm hoping that we can get some turn meter reduction here. Doesn't look like it. So it's going to take a little bit of time before everything gets cycled through, it looks like. But I'm pretty sure this runs 100%. It's been a very long time since I've been in this account, though, to actually test this out. So we're about to see if this runs actually 100% or not, but it should be. If I recall correctly, that is. That's his ability that would have reduced turn meter there. Unfortunately, he used that at the wrong time. Surprise, surprise. Coldheart does that all the time as well. So we're not really missing out on anything there. Once he can actually hit the Fire Knight, it should be basically game over. Now, I believe Tomb Lord does bring a slow, which definitely helps a ton with not making him have to do as much, not rushing him completely. Slow helps out a ton. Now, this is a slow run, but my Armiger, I believe, is sitting at about, I think he's right around 200 speed, 100% crit rate for sure, and probably like 230 accuracy or something. But 200 speed, 200 accuracy, 100% crit rate, perfect build for Armiger. Once the shield gets knocked down, once we get a decreased speed applied, which it is now, once we get this shield knocked down, we should be clear, free, and in the clear as far as keeping his turn meter down low enough to where the Fire Knight doesn't hit us anymore, I believe. But if you're running like a budget build and you don't have Coldheart like me on this account, then Armiger is definitely a champion worth investing in, especially to like pair very well with a Scarab King. I personally, especially if you're early game, I don't like investing in champions who I know I'm not going to use in like multiple different areas of the game. I like to use champions who I know, hey, I'm going to use this champion in Fire Knight. I'm going to use this champion in Spiders, which he's very good in Spiders as well. I can show you guys a little snippet of that. But very good in Spiders, very good in Fire Knight, very good in Ice Golem as well. Very good against the Scarab King. So don't use him in Dragon, obviously. Dragon's not the place to use him. One, he's weak affinity against the Dragon. But two, you can't reduce the turn meter on the Dragon. So he brings no real benefit to the table there. Now, this is a long run, but you guys get the point. I'm going to go ahead and fast forward to the end of the run. Nobody wants to sit here and watch this 10-minute Fire Knight run. It's not fast. It's not pretty. But it does work. I'll be right back at the end. All right, guys. So we finished that Fire Knight run. 7 minutes and 54 seconds. Blazing fast. All right. So if you guys wanted to see me do an account takeover, an account review on my old account, this account literally hasn't been played regularly for a few months now. There's a lot of stuff I can go back and give my opinions on, because what I know now versus what I know then are very, very different. So if you guys would be interested in seeing something like how I used to gear my champions versus how I'd gear them now a few months down the road after learning things, let me know. I'll be more than happy to do that. I think it can make some interesting content. Now, let me jump in here and show you guys my Armiger's stats. So he's looking at 201 speed, perfect, 103% crit rate, 176 accuracy. These are literally the only three stats you need, all right? If you can keep him alive, you'd be found one HP, okay? One attack, one defense, all right? If you're just an absolute bare bones, minimum requirement, just get him fast, accurate, and 100% crit rate. The reason why I say the 100% crit rate is because you need crit in order to reduce turn meter. Decreases the turn meter by 30% if, big if, this attack is critical. Get him 100% crit rate. You have to have accuracy in order to actually reduce the turn meter. I would prefer this to be like 200 for dungeon stages 20. Now, if you're only using him against like the Fire Knight or the Scarab King, you can go with 85% crit rate, I believe it is, because you get a 15% built in. I don't necessarily recommend doing that, especially if you plan to use him in Spiders or anywhere else in the game. So go ahead, get him fast, accurate, and 100% crit rate. There's other champions who need to be built the exact same way as Armiger, such as Allure. You have those champions, build them the same way. Now, when it comes to his masteries, he does not need masteries, to be honest. You can get the Evil Eye ability, which helps you reduce a little bit more turn meter. You can get these to give yourself a little bit more accuracy. But in reality, he doesn't need any masteries whatsoever. Like, he's there for one job and one job only, unless you're building him to do damage, all right? So if you're building him for a consistent, fast turn meter reduction champion, do this build. Now, if you have the gear to do damage and do turn meter reduction, then by all means, give him a lot of crit damage, give him a lot of defense, he's a defense-based champion, give him all the speed in the world and make him super accurate. But this is like a very basic beginner's build. Hey, I need a turn meter reduction champion. I don't have anything else, so can you help me out? Excellent champion, very, very free to play, very, very budget-friendly gear when it comes to that. And let me show you my other champions just so you get an idea. Okay, my Kayle, garbage tier gear. My Yannicka, I don't know how you say her name, decent gear, okay? Nothing crazy here whatsoever. We had Arbiter, she's pitiful, dude. She guys wearing concrete boots, okay? Basically what this is, she's slow-ish for where this account is in the game. She's pretty slow, 285. We also had, I don't even know who else I had, to be honest, in that run. Doesn't really matter, I don't think. We had Tomb Lord, okay? Yeah, Tomb Lord, very similar. 156, oh my gosh. I'd be roasting my account so hard. I don't even know who built this. This is awful. Level 8 boots? Why? Are those not upgraded? Okay, so apparently somebody hacked my account and it looks like this now. So there's definitely some more champions I could bring in. There's definitely a lot of stuff that could be fixed in this account. But overall, guys, that is how good Armiger is. Also, look at this, my Spider's Den. Same exact thing. I use Armiger. I mean, granted, I have miscreated Monster and Tayrell, so big shields, HP burn, very helpful. But Armiger is crucial when it comes to decreasing the big spider's turn meter consistently. This team doesn't have a slow, has some turn meter reduction with Tayrell and Ultimate Gaelic, but Armiger is the most consistent. The thing is, when you run Armiger, unless if you're running only one of them, you do need to bring some other turn meter reduction, 30%, unless he's like super, super fast or has decreased speed. The bosses and enemies are going to catch up to him. So if you could throw somebody in there who's like 100% fully depletes the turn meter, or like 50% turn meter every 3 or 4 turns, that's perfect. You just need somebody to help Armiger that if he does fall behind and does miss a turn meter reduction, that you can pick it up. No problem, okay? Hopefully this helps you out, guys. If you're looking for something to fill in for the Scarab King and you're like, I don't really want to invest in a champion I'm only going to use in the Doom Tower just to pick up this whopping, what, 100 energy? Okay, well, keep this in mind. You can use Armiger in a lot of other places. Obviously, you can gear him out for damage and get a lot of a value out of him that way as well. So keep that in mind. Hope this video helps you out, guys. Thank you all very much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Feel free to click one of the videos after this, which is about to pop up on the left and right hand side. Thank you again. I wish you all a Merry Christmas, and I'll see you in the next video.